While their opponents may have changed, Mr. Thompson has assured me the plan stays the same. It is the tag team of Mr. Thompson and the Prince of Perth, Jay Taylor!
Hello and welcome to EPW Go Time! We are here at the Point Mirror on the 7th of September 2024. This is a new thing for Explosive Pro Wrestling. We're so glad to have you here with us. It is Dean Olsen joining on the call alongside Mr. Drake Wallace.
Thank you very much, Dean. I am pumped to be here as always. Incredible. First time ever Go Time. Maybe by name, we've had pre-shows before. Always something that we tell the EPW fans, get down here early. Make sure you see those pre-show matches. You see the future of Explosive Pro Wrestling. Get in the ring. But tonight we take it to the next level. We take it to Go Time.
That is correct. It is unmissable each and every time. As we have our first combatants in the ring and Chili having a horrid sight in front of him with Jay Taylor.
We don't know their opponents though. This will be a fun surprise.
Who's it going to be?
And their opponents.
Oh.
From Gosnells, Western Australia, weighing in at Mr. Thompson's Dream Queen weight. He'd be a queen to Mr. T, but tonight for you, he's King Shahill.
I'm a massive fan of King Shahill. So good to have him back at Explosive Pro Wrestling and joining us for the inaugural Go Time. We are here in the wings of Maryland and we are going for a huge show in EPW's Vendetta 2024.
And his tag team partner.
Oh, here we go.
The big boy himself.
From good old Morley, standing at definitely over 6 foot tall, he is the big boy, Ryan Rivers!
What an incredible pairing. What an incredible surprise pairing we have. King Shahill, you said you love him. I definitely love him. Full of pizzazz, full of piss and vinegar. And Mr. Big Boy himself, Ryan Rivers. Oh, what a test in front of the locker room leadership program.
That's right, we're leading up to EPW's Vendetta 2024. You can check that out on Vimeo and be sure that you do. As always, look up EPW on all forms of social media at EPW Perth. We've got a huge night ahead of us and it's all kicking off right here on Go Time with some tag team action. The locker room leadership program led by Mr. Thompson, joined by the Prince of Perth, Jay Taylor, is up against this team of King Shahill and Ryan Rivers, who have been called in at the last minute, and I hope they're ready for a fight.
Ah, surely. Look, let's tell it how it is. The locker room leadership program prepared for one thing, and now they've been delivered another thing. They are the tag team, so they have the tag team experience. But that kind of goes out the door now because surprise opponents, and what two amazing surprise opponents they have. I'm up for this.
Simon as well. It is going time right here. Explosive Pro Wrestling and it's about to get underway. Massive night ahead. Let's go. We are Tyler Sparks keeping a keen eye on the action for this one. As the crowd's gotten in nice and early tonight here at the point, which is good.
Sure have.
You're still making their way in.
Nice and early, nice and loud too.
That's what you gotta do, but in Go Time, we're gonna be having this match. We're gonna be seeing an invitational tournament qualifying final as well, which is always exciting. Invitational tournament this year has just stepped in the lineup.
Yeah, unbelievable to have such a high caliber match at Go Time. Another reason to check it out on YouTube and obviously to get here early to see Go Time in the future.
Chit-chatting between King Shahill and Ryan Rivers. Okay, Shahill's going to take it off now. Here we go. I thought we're going to see Ryan Rivers kick off the action, but Shahill's taken over. Mr. Thompson, as always, has his Christmas cleanest white polo shirt.
I'm checking his mum washes that for him.
Can't pull it out. Here we go. Collar and elbow tie up. Straight underway. And oh, King Shahill looks like he's going for a lip lock.
Look, I wouldn't say I wouldn't want to see it. It's the 21st century, man. Get with the times. He's got a big boy shirt on. Lovely.
Tag team cohesion. You don't see that with the locker room leadership program.
That's true. Yeah, maybe we could get Jay Taylor in one of those tidy whitey shirts.
He's applying his own waist lock so he can gyrate.
I've never seen a waist like that one before.
Thompson's calling for a disqualification.
Oh! Nice shot. Oh, nice shot by King Shaquille there.
Like I said, the pizzazz and the cool is gone. King Shaquille is unmeasurable. Tagging in the big boy now.
Yeah, you think King Shaquille's a big boy? You're talking about the big boy right here. What has he got in store? Look at these two.
Big body avalanche in the corner from the big boy. He's a former Pride champion as well. If you catch out the ESPW shows down at the School of Pro Wrestling.
Cohesive tag team action here. We love it.
You said at the start of this matchup that it would be the other way around, right?
That's what I thought. That's what you would think, right? Locker room leadership program, being a team for quite some time now, had much success with it. But the big boys, let's call them, really taking it to Mr. Thompson here.
In their own neutral corner as well. Smart tag team. And some tag team offense to go with it. How good.
Cover here by Ryan Rivers. Jay Taylor in, breaking up the pin. Oh, Ryan Rivers taking Jay Taylor out of the game here. Jay Taylor having a few words with people in the crowd. Needs to stay on it because, as you can tell, the big boys are on it. They're ready to go. So Jay Taylor needs to stay focused. Blind tag.
Oh, there you go. Jay Taylor, of course, has a lot to prove. He lost a matchup to Edith Knight on the last Sunday. He was down at Hell or High Water on the pre-show, which predates Go Time. He was facing against the corner of the ring apron. That is going to do some serious damage.
And you can see Mr. Thompson absolutely loving it. See one of his pupils. Jay Taylor taking it to the big boy Ryan Rivers on the outside. A few barks to the crowd. Don't know what that means, but good on him for that one.
Of course, speaking of all pupils from the locker room leadership program, as Jay Taylor just levels Rivers with a great clothesline. Takes his time making the pin, and that's the result you get. Of course, fellow locker room leadership program member Roger Cargis will be out in action tonight defending his Coastal Championship that he won at Hell or High Water. Very keen to see how that one goes.
Yeah, huge victory for Cargis over Bruno Nitro to claim his first major championship in Explosive Pro Wrestling. Nice butterfly suplex there by Jay Taylor.
Right, of course, that matchup will take place on EPW's Vendetta, which you can check out on Vimeo. Tag made now. Mr. Thompson back into the action with Jay Taylor. Looks like he's not ready to go to the outside yet. Oh, big scoop slam for the big boy.
Well, Mr. Thompson setting up here, running his own beep test, beeping over the big boy, and a nice elbow from Mr. Thompson. Jay Taylor running the beep test as well.
He's doing a bit slow, Mr. Thompson.
You don't want to see me do the beep test. Oh, nice knee there by Jay Taylor.
Press, and the big boy gets the shoulder off the mat. King Shaquille is just itching to get back into this matchup right here.
You can see Ryan Rivers absolutely desperate to make that tag. We talk about chopping off the ring. Well, the locker room leadership program have taken control of this matchup, and Ryan Rivers is getting the absolute tar beaten out of him right now. Desperate, you can see King Shaquille desperate to make that tag.
Drop toe hold right in the middle of the ring. Hold onto the ankle and the leg of Rivers as he makes another tag. There you go to Mr. Thompson.
Veteran experience there from Jay Taylor. We know the accolades that come with Jay Taylor, the experience that he has. You can see the drop toe hold, held the leg, got the tag, and now in comes Mr. Thompson to continue the beatdown of Ryan Rivers.
I mean, Jay Taylor's been in the game for a very long time. I don't want to do maths because I'm terrible at it, but dare I say, Jay Taylor's years in the ring may be the combination of the combined years of the other three competitors in this matchup.
Yeah, you wouldn't be far off it. I mean, he's definitely one of the most experienced men in the entire Explosive Pro Wrestling locker room right now.
Speaking of experienced EPW wrestlers, we're going to see Tyler Jacobs in a matchup later on at EPW's Vendetta, which could very well be the last time we see him. He says he is
Yeah, surely, maybe another loss for Tyler Jacobs might mean that's all she wrote. Let's hope that doesn't happen. Good friend of mine, Tyler Jacobs, and I wouldn't want to see him go out like that.
Meet both Jay Taylor with a hard shot to the midsection of Ryan Rivers, who's really feeling it right now. He needs that tag, and he needs it very, very soon. Interesting to see who gets a win over here, because obviously the tag team championships will be on the line tonight. The tag team division here at Explosive Pro Wrestling has been going gangbusters lately. Maybe we'll see Shahill and Ryan Rivers make a challenge soon. Maybe we'll see Mr. Thompson and Jay Taylor make a challenge soon.
Absolutely. I'd love to see either of these teams challenge for the EPW Tag Team Championship. Look at Mr. Thompson. He is loving it. Loves to see his opponents getting punished. Always has a game plan. Maybe, have to alter the game plan slightly for the new opponents, but it seems to be working out perfectly for him.
He's a
teacher.
He'll change the curriculum to whoever his opponents are as he's charging up right now. Taking a bit of time to draw Jack and kick Shahill. I'll tell you what, you want to talk trash with Shahill, you come off second best. Opportunity now for Rivers to make a tag.
It has to be it.
So close. Oh, Jay Taylor goes down and out to the concrete floor. Oh, Jay Taylor.
At the very last moment, Jay Taylor pulled King Shahill off the apron. Ryan Rivers not able to make that tag. Mr. Thompson has done his dirty work back on the outside, and Jay Taylor come in to clean up the mess. Back in Mr. Thompson. Not in a rush to get in, definitely. A slow pace for Mr. Thompson.
Since they took advantage of the matchup, they've definitely been dictating the pace of the matchup. Things on their terms. And Mr. Thompson now has got Ryan Rivers up on a fireman's carry. What are we going to see here? Apparently nothing, because Ryan Rivers got out of it. Thompson's on the outside of the apron. Taylor's getting involved now.
Unbelievable, man.
Tom's boxing to get some order.
Underneath.
Oh, through the legs.
There it is.
Tag made. Shahill's in. Here we go. Out goes Thompson. Ducks the clothesline. Step up into Guri. Upside the head of Jay Taylor. Fakes him out.
Nice.
There we go. That's what the fans want to see. Oh, fisherman suplex.
Cover from Shahill. One, two.
Oh.
Really thought he had it. What a huge victory that would have been for King Shahill and Ryan Rivers. You talk about tag team championships. If they have a victory tonight against the Locker Room Leadership Program, surely that puts them high on the charts as who's next in contention.
Oh! Taylor with the cutter to King Shahill. Boot to the face of Rivers. Whilst the referee's back was turned, of course. Oh, come on.
And here is your winner, the Locker Room Leadership Program.
Yeah, look, we sort of knew that might be the way it turned out. We were hopeful it wasn't going to be. Big King Shahill fan Ryan Rivers, a superstar on the rise in Explosive Pro Wrestling. But the Locker Room Leadership, too strong. The bond that they have, too much for the big boys. And a big victory for Mr. Thompson and Jay Taylor.
The following contest is a singles match set for one fall. Introducing first, from Adelaide, South Australia, representing TMDK, weighing in at 204 pounds, the world beater, Damian Slater!
And here he is, the world beater, Damian Slater, alongside Dustin Connors, of course, whose knee has made a miraculous recovery. He was injured, as we saw about a week ago, and couldn't have his match in the pen. with Solomon Blackwell tonight, but he's made a miraculous recovery. His knee's doing fine. Who would have thought?
Well, look, when you're a specimen like Damian Slater, recovery is what it's all about. He can recover from the biggest injuries at the drop of a hat, and you love to see it, because if there's an EPW show, I want to make sure that a superstar like Damian Slater is always on it.
I'm a massive fan of Damian Slater, and at Hell or High Water, he kind of took the piss a bit. We've seen the pen with Solomon Blackwell. What we saw was the World Beater Dojo match, where Damian Slater basically beat and embarrassed, like, what, three or four EPW trainees?
Oh, you could say it that way. I would say he gave three EPW trainees an opportunity to show what they could do. I mean, that's almost like, he's like charity. He's like World Vision, you know? He's giving to the poor, and he destroyed the boy. He killed them, let's be real.
I mean, he did.
And his opponent. Accompanied to the ring by Harry, representing the House of Free Spirits, weighing in at 145 pounds, Tiger Heart, Faizal Ali.
Speaking about young EPW competitors getting an amazing opportunity, Faizal Ali stepping up to Damian Slater here tonight, representing the House of Free Spirits and accompanied by Harry, the young boy. This is going to be an interesting matchup. I really do like the work that I've seen of Faizal Ali. Whilst he is a little bit of a newcomer, Damian Slater is a seasoned veteran as can be. You look at him, he's got the gear on, which shows he means business. This isn't his regular pro wrestling attire. This is a man who's very proficient in the arts of Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, freestyle wrestling, as well as catch-as-catch-can pro wrestling. He's ready to go. Look at that.
He better be ready to go. He's up against someone the caliber of Damian Slater.
And many people have said that since Jesse Lamb defeated Slater and won the EPW Championship, Slater feels that people are forgetting just what he's capable of, which is why he's putting on these showcases of his skills and his, more proficient arts of fighting that he is so good at. He thinks that up-and-comers like Blackwell are just taking the spotlight and thinks that they are ready to show people what the next generation are capable of. But Damian Slater is not done yet, and dare I say, he's far from done yet. He's toying with Faizal Ali now. Oh, springboard crossbody!
Nice crossbody by Ali there. I was going to say, if they've forgotten, Damian Slater's going to be quick to remind them, but Ali has different things in store. Nice leg
kick. There you go. This is where things get dangerous. You're in there with a master like Slater. Oh! Step up enziguri there by Faizal Ali.
Slides under the rope. Nice midsection. Hits to the midsection. Float over.
Sunset flip there by Ali. Only a two count. Of course, very different to what we saw at Hell or High Water when we were in there with the trainees of school for wrestling. Jesus! Of course. Lots of great action happening here tonight in Merrow for EPW's Vendetta. Make sure you check it out on Vimeo. World Beater Damian Slater taking part in the inaugural EPW Go Time, showcasing what he's all about. Interesting that he's wearing his MMA attire and training gear. He's not wearing his knee pads, he's not wearing his trunks.
It's a different feel to the fight here. I wouldn't say that Damian Slater is going to be taking it lightly, but maybe not showing as much respect to Ali as he would some of his other opponents, which, you know, could be his undoing. I mean, imagine if Ali got a victory tonight against Damian Slater. Who am I kidding? Never mind.
Anyone getting a win over Damian Slater has got a massive credential to their record. The fact that Jesse Lambert not only got a win over Damian Slater, but won the EPW Championship in the process, I think is what led us to this change within Damian Slater. He feels like he has to let these younger competitors know, and he's taking him to task for it.
Yeah, 100%. I mean, he is sick and tired of all these youngsters making a mockery of professional wrestling. We know how seriously Damian Slater takes professional wrestling, and he's about to show these youngsters what it's all about. Just like he is there.
Oh,
Ali's
tapping
out, and a huge victory, a nice quick victory from Damian Slater.
And here is your winner, the World Beater.
good showing from Ali there, but as we predicted, Damian Slater making light work of the youngster. I'm sure it won't be the last we see of Ali, but Slater, I'm not sure he's sweating, I'm not sure he's puffing, but he definitely was challenged. But a nice victory there from Slater as he moves on.
This is a quarter-final match in Australia's longest-running wrestling tournament, the EPW Invitational Tournament. Introducing first... accompanied by the Great George, representing the House of Free Spirits. From Scarborough, Western Australia, weighing in at 175 pounds, Daddy Cool, Hayden Zenith.
Yeah, what an incredible matchup here. The final qualifying matchup in the Invitational Tournament. Match here. Great George picking up a water bottle from the desk. He's a crazy guy.
It's not like we need it or anything.
He's never sure what's going on with the Great George.
You used to do that back in the day.
I did do that. Yeah.
You did.
Yeah, it was fun. Did I spit it on you, Red Bull?
No, you're just an asshole in general.
That's fair.
And his opponent. From the gothic beaches of Alkmos. Weighing in at 196 pounds, he is the Darkest Soul, Robbie Heart!
Of course, this matchup is highly anticipated. These two had a matchup earlier this year, about 5 months ago it was, and it was that black miss of Robbie Heart, which is the reason that Hayden Zenith is currently wearing an eye patch. He's not been able to see properly out of that eye ever since. Of course, if you follow EPW on all forms of social media, as you should, at EPW Perth, Hayden Zenith, he posted a video where he says that for 5 months, I've wrestled with this eye patch. It's taken away wrestling, family time, and work. And it's with all this pain and suffering that he's endured that he's now going to throw back at Robbie Heart.
We know this matchup is to see who will go through to the semi-finals at the Invitational Tournament, but it really is a grudge match. You can see the animosity that these two have for each other because of what's gone on in the past. It'll be interesting to see if someone like Hayden Zenith can really keep his emotions in check, because you know he's an emotional guy. He carries his heart on his sleeve. Will he be able to keep that in check against someone the caliber of Robbie Heart? What the hell is Great George doing?
He's got goggles on to protect his eyes.
Oh, I guess that does make sense. Oh, Hayden Zenith.
Oh, he's taking the eye patch off.
Removing the eye patch.
The eye must be all healed up now. I don't think Robbie Heart was expecting that, nor did any of us. And here we go, just pummeling shots here. Like you said, this is almost reminiscent of a grudge match that just so happens to be a qualifying final matchup in the EPW Invitational Tournament, which of course is the longest running pro wrestling tournament in all of Australia. Great George is on the outside. He got a win over Robbie Heart at Hell or High Water. Also, was the first person to make Robbie Heart tap out. He had never submitted before until he stepped into the ring with the Great George at Hell or High Water.
Jeez, I did not know that. That's incredible.
Huge.
I mean, we know how much of a technician Robbie Heart is to make him submit. Incredible achievement. But here's the wrinkle. The winner of this match, their opponent in the semi-final, the Great George.
And that's right. Zenith has said he'll happily take on the Great George, and they'll do everything fair and down the middle should he get the victory over Robbie Heart. Heart on the other side, after getting that loss from Great George, he said that Zenith is going to be his next sacrifice.
I don't think if it's Robbie Heart versus Great George, I don't think it'll be fair and just. I think Robbie Heart will be out for blood.
You better believe it. Shot to the throat. I gotta say, I absolutely love the work of Robbie Heart. There's something so sick and twisted about it that I love.
The thing I love, he comes out and the fans almost don't know what to do. There's like this eerie silence, like an aura about him. Like, what the hell are we seeing here? And then he gets in the ring and demolishes his opponents. incredible wrestler, sometimes underrated, but has held championships all over Australia.
Yeah, that's right. When he made the move from South Australia to West Australia, I was absolutely thrilled to have him part of the EPW roster. And he's hoping we see more and more of Robbie Heart going forward. Not just an explosive pro wrestler, but right here on Go Time, as we're in the lead up to EPW's Vendetta. Give it a look. Vimeo Zenith now making his way up to the stage with the hair of Robbie Heart and a hard shot to the back of the head. Guys are getting a little bit closer to our end of the building wall. You don't like it, you're getting nervous.
They better get back in the ring because the referee's about to count him out. He's up to a count of seven now. Oh, big shot by Zenith there.
Three tiny sparks. Up to the count of eight. Oh, what a shot.
Arm strike by Zenith. Not even sure what happens if there's a count out here. Double count out. A bye, yeah, surely both get eliminated. Robbie Heart back in. Zenith has to get in quickly.
Springboard. Here we go. Double springboard crossbody by Zenith. Will it be enough? Not this time. Robbie Heart gets the shoulder up. The Gotham beaches of Okomos.
I still never visited. I wonder what they look like.
You've lived in Western Australia for some time, right?
I don't go that
you've
far.
You've seen our beaches, right?
Yeah, but it's goth. Are they black? Is it black sand? I think it's black sand. Like UK, right?
Maybe.
Hayden Zenith won't be seeing those beaches anytime soon. He's seeing the foot of Robbie Heart as it's driven into his throat.
You say that, but he's at least seen clearly taking off that eye patch. It worked for the last 5 months, all because of Robbie Heart. And you know Robbie Heart came into this one expecting that patch to be on, expecting that advantage. But a lot of people all have been taking advantage of the more impaired vision of Zenith.
Yeah, nice little ruse by Zenith there. Playing a little bit of a mind game, playing a bit of trickery on Robbie Heart. Oh, nice! Hurricane Rana then taking Robbie Heart over. Heart to the outside. Zenith desperate to get the crowd into it. We know how much the EPW faithful love Hayden Zenith. And they love to see him fly. No! Basement slide drop kick to Robbie Heart. What is he gearing up for here?
Your guess is as good as mine. Zenith is so unpredictable. He's about to get some airtime here at Go Time. Here we know. Oh, he's just put the ring open over the head of Zenith. Unorthodox offense there by Robbie Heart, but beautifully executed as well.
Incredible wrestling IQ there from Robbie Heart. Don't let the looks deceive you. An intelligent man, Robbie Heart, is using every part of the ring to his advantage. Throwing Zenith in as he climbs the ropes to inflict more punishment.
Here comes Heart. Oh, big double stomp right to the center of the spine. Serious damage, but will it be enough to get the shoulders down for a count of three? Not this time.
Zenith knows what's in store here. A place in the semi-finals of, hold on, one, two. Able to kick out again. A place in the semi-finals of the longest running tournament in all of Australian wrestling. Robbie Heart, another cover there. Zenith kicks out one more time. Mounted punches from Robbie Heart here. Showing some frustration. What is it going to take from Robbie Heart here to get the job done on Hayden Zenith to move through to the semi-finals and to face the Great George in the next round of the Invitational Tournament? To the spine. They're really targeting that spine, the back of Hayden Zenith, softening him up.
It's a frustration to see here on Robbie Heart here tonight, especially as he's gone for so many pins and so many ways to finish this matchup. There's just no way he's getting those shoulders down for the count of three. Like you said, it's a bit of a grudge match as much as it's a semi-final matchup in the Invitational Tournament. We're just seeing some cracks in the offense of Robbie Heart where he is showing signs of frustration and probably throwing it off whatever game plan that he came in with.
Yeah, you feel like it's going to take maybe a combination of high impact moves to keep someone like Hayden Zenith down, who really has been on a tear in the Invitational Tournament.
He's just going to take another blast of the black mist.
He needs to put those goggles on.
It's not the dumbest idea.
It would look dumb, but it might work.
Oh, what a shot by Zenith!
Huge counter there by Hayden
Holy
Zenith.
Holy hell!
drop kick to the guts of Robbie Heart there. What's he setting him up for? Gets him up, float over by Robbie Heart.
He's going for a German suplex, but Zenith put the brakes on, goes through the legs backwards. Springboard and a huge
that might be
body. Here we go, no! Of course, it's do or die in these semi-finals. You take a loss and you are out of the tournament. Everyone wants to win this tournament. It gives you a championship matchup of your choosing. Should you win, Falcon Arrow, is it enough? We are about to find out.
No, Robbie Heart kicking out. Unbelievable combination there by Hayden Zenith. Trying to get Robbie Heart up once, twice, rolled through, got him up, hit that Falcon's Arrow. I really thought that was it, but Robbie Heart able to kick out. Close to that three count. The crowd coming to life here for Hayden Zenith.
It's go time, and I mean that in a metaphorical sense, not just the name of the show. Ooh. Yeah. Shot there by Robbie Heart. He's got himself perched up. Big knife edge chopped to the chest. He's in a very difficult spot right now.
Robbie Heart setting Zenith up for that superplex. Zenith able to fight out, punches to that midsection. Heart goes down face first. Zenith has him where he wants him.
He's going to go for the Zenton bomb. He nails it, surely that's it. Oh, look out. Ho-ho! How about that? Oh, but it's not enough to get the win over Robbie Heart.
Incredible balance, incredible athleticism there. But Robbie Heart still able to kick out. As we said, we know how much this means, a huge victory on the horizon for one of these two men. Big kick there by Robbie Heart, flies in. Sling Blade takes Zenith down, has to stay on him now, can't let Zenith get no momentum back. Oh, beautiful Michinoku driver there from Robbie Heart. This is it, one, two, counter ref. No, no! Zenith kicking out at the absolute last moment there. Unbelievable. Great George, you can see shouting encouragement from the ring apron there.
Crowd is a harsh with awe. The fact that Zenith managed to get the shoulder up after that Michinoku driver. Robbie Heart himself, look at him shaking his head. He's mystified in how the hell Daddy Cool got his damn shoulder off that mat.
Robbie Heart setting him up here. Oh, nice flying forearm there. Sets him up. Another, no. I thought he was going for another Michinoku driver. Hangs him over that rope. Zenith in a very difficult position here. Springboard knee from Robbie Heart taking Zenith. You can see the grimace on Zenith's face. That's surely it. One, two. Oh, again. Unbelievable here. Zenith kicking out one more time. If the frustration wasn't in already, it's in now. Robbie Heart clearly unsure what needs to be done to get the victory and to move on to the semi-finals.
Each step forward in the invitation, the stakes get higher and higher, and people dig deeper and deeper, which is exactly what we're seeing here at Explosive Pro Wrestling's Go Time in Marowa. We have got Robbie Heart benched up on the second rope, and oh, Zenith with a boot to the side of the face.
Got Robbie Heart where he wants him. Going for that Hurricane Runner. Nice roll through for Robbie Heart. No, kicks out at the last moment. Rolls through, sets him up. Oh, no, can't get it. Oh, he's got it. Snakes away from Hayden Zenith.
There it comes. Locking in the snake's way, but he's so close. Oh, Robbie Heart with a genius move right there. It may not be fair, but it got him out of that predicament. They could have cost him the matchup.
Had my view obscured there. I'm not sure what went on. Obviously, the referee, not only in my way, but in the way of Hayden Zenith. I'm sure he didn't cheat. Maybe Robbie Heart kept it down the middle.
He was in the snake's way. He pulled referee Tyler's fights into Hayden Zenith to get in and out of the move. Quite smart, dare I say. Devious is all hell. Carry on.
Do you have a referee shot? I'd love to see him right there.
Maybe one day. But make sure you follow EPW on all forms of social media. This is Go Time, as we are moments away from Vendetta. The great George has his goggles on. The goggles do something!
The goggles do something! The miss blocked by the goggles.
Zenith with the miss to the face of Robbie Heart. Payback in its purest form.
Rolls him up. One, two, three.
He's done it!
And here is your winner, Dirty Cool, Hayden Zenith!
Hayden Zenith will go on to the next round of the Invitational Tournament. His opponent will be the great George. This matchup was absolutely fantastic, and I can't wait to see what is next in the Invitational Tournament, Wally.
You talk about having a game plan and making it work. These two boys definitely knew what Robbie Heart had in store. The great George coming out with the goggles. I thought it was ridiculous, but the plan worked. And Hayden Zenith through to the semi-finals of the Invitational Tournament.
And this has been EPW's Go Time. We'd like to thank you for joining us. We are moments away from Explosive Pro Wrestling's Vendetta. Make sure you check it out on Vimeo. Follow EPW on all forms of social media at EPW Perth. On behalf of Drake Wells, myself, Dean Olsen, this has been EPW's Go Time. Thanks for joining us.